Hi, we are Shivanshi and Daniela, and today we are going to talk about multimedia databases. These are some of the points that we are going to cover in this presentation. What is a multimedia database? A multimedia database is a repository of different data objects, like dates, graphical images, video clips, sound files, etc. In other words, a multimedia database is a database that hosts one or more primary media types, such as documents, images, videos, or audio. For example, Flashy Popcorns that stores a large number of videos and allows users to browse and search them by keywords can be considered as a multimedia database. Other examples of multimedia database applications include movies on demand, home shopping, photographic libraries, art gallery, and museum management. There are three main categories for multimedia databases: static media that are time independent, such as image; dynamic media that are time dependent, such as video; or dimensional media, such as 3D games.
After knowing what multimedia data is all about, we'll understand what multimedia database management system is. It's basically a system which is intended to store and manipulate multimedia data. It acts as an interface between the users of the multimedia applications and multimedia database. This system aids the process to store, transport, and display multimedia data for the various applications. It enables users to perform various operations like modification, deletion, comparison, and evaluation on multimedia data. There are three types of multimedia database management systems, namely relational database management system, object-oriented database management system, and object-relational database management system. First, we'll be talking about the relational database management system. It basically stores everything as first normal form tables. All the data items are atomic and can be related to another record in the table using the foreign key concept. In this type of the database management system, all records are identified by the content itself, and it becomes really difficult to extend the set of domains. Oracle DBMS and SQL 3, which is an extension to standard SQL, serve as examples of multimedia relational database management systems. Second we have is object-oriented database management system. This type of the DBMS stores all the data in the form of classes of objects. Data items are referenced as components of objects. As classes are extensible, we can freely create different types of data type domains. Jasmine is an example of object-oriented database management system and has an application known as Studio as its development environment. It comes with various built-in classes like picture, image, video, and audio. These classes come with compression and manipulation facilities and are compatible with Java Media Framework. Third we have is the object relational database management system. It comprises of relations which are not in first normal form. Data in this database management system can be either an atomic value or an object reference. It also gives provision to define new types. Oracle's Intermedia is the best example of object relational database management system. It supports multimedia storage, retrieval, and management of data type domains like blobs, B files, URLs, and streaming audio and video. Intermedia also provides the ORD audio, ORD video, and ORD image object types and methods for managing and performing manipulation operations on multimedia data. Now we'll be talking about the multimedia database architecture. This architecture basically varies depending on the type of application. However, all the architectures basically comprise of two main components: database processing and multimedia data pre-processing system. Database processing involves querying of multimedia database management system by the users using query interface, and based on the query, multimedia data like audio, video is searched and manipulated. Multimedia data pre-processing system provides additional information to handle the query based on the type of the database management system used. Now we'll be covering about the multimedia data domain types. Multimedia database management system typically provides three different kinds of domain for multimedia data: large object domain, which basically comprises sequence of data of two kinds, binary large objects, which are called as blobs, that are unstructured sequence of bytes, character large objects known as clobs, which are unstructured sequence of characters. Then we have file references, which contain the link to the data, such as object linking and embedding method, which is used in Access. The third one we have is the genuine multimedia data types like Jasmine and Oracle, which we discussed previously. Multimedia data types allow the use of structure of data while querying and manipulation. Blobs and clobs allow to extract and concatenate sections. An example of using binary data to refer to the music file is explained here. File reference, as shown in the example, specifies the URL to the media data. Database management system has no access to the actual data in the case of the file reference.
Now I'm going to talk about multimedia queries. Multimedia query language must deal with complex spatial and temporal relationships inherited in the wide range of multimedia data types. Due to the complexity of multimedia data, it is necessary a query data language that could support semantic data retrieval, which is done by using keywords, indexes on keywords, and contents on multimedia objects. Several methods for extraction of future values require use of advanced algorithms based on artificial intelligence, artificial neural networks and fuzzy logic, and computer visions. There are two types of queries that are used in multimedia database systems. The first one is well-defined query. A well-defined query is when properties of objects are represented by well-defined set of labels. The conditional operators are also well-defined. In well-defined query, the user must know the exact knowledge of the underlying database and the desired query result. This query only works with exact matches. The second one is the fuzzy query. The properties of query objects are unclear, and comparison operators do not give exact matches. This will result in a set of different answers. Because user preferences in what should be retrieved are often vague or imprecise, fuzzy queries can meet the search conditions. Now I'm going to tell about the advantage of using multimedia databases. When a multimedia application content is controlled by a multimedia database, multimedia content can be added, deleted, or modified without modifying the application script. Another advantage is that multimedia databases make the multimedia data structure logic available to multimedia applications and simplify the scripts. Finally, multimedia databases can be used by multiple multimedia applications, which add great value to multimedia data through reuse and control redundancy. The disadvantage. The creation, storage, and data modeling techniques for multimedia data objects and retrieval of objects are main issues in the development of multimedia databases. Other issues include authenticity, integrity, scheduling, and quality of multimedia delivery over the network. In conclusion, while creating digital media is not expensive, it is generally expensive to manage and distribute it. Browsing large multimedia databases can become complex and will demand faster and more efficient algorithms for indexing and retrieval of structures. This research area is becoming really important, and researchers are constantly working on more efficient algorithms for indexing and retrieval of multimedia data structures. Thank you.